for me and for my husband, it meant relief from suffering.
For Barbara Garlock, accessing medically assisted dying was an act of love on her part and her late husband's.
I have never regretted that that was the decision that was made.
Garlock says her husband Gail's quality of life was deteriorating due to dementia, and they were forced to look for new doctors to consent to the request after being turned down by another who didn't believe Gail met the criteria.
I believe the issue of MAID is profoundly personal.
Now the Senate is proposing to let people make their request before dementia takes away their ability to consent.
As someone with a history of dementia in my family, I seek the peace of mind that an advance request and consent to it will provide.
Another Senate amendment affects the proposed ban on assisted dying for people suffering solely from mental illness. The ban would only last 18 months.
We need free therapy before we can offer people death as a form of therapy.
Disability advocates are calling for more safeguards to protect people who lack mental health support.
I get worried about people right now in this pandemic who are experiencing extreme poverty, who are experiencing extreme hardship and don't have any resources and will choose death as a solution because it's the only option that they can see or put their hands on.
Meanwhile, Garlock is also concerned that the changes the Senate proposed won't pass in the House of Commons.
My heart breaks for anyone who is made to suffer one more day than needed.
So, Olivia, the Senate debate ends tomorrow. The bill then goes back to MPs, and then what?
Adrienne, the government will only have about 10 days to pass this bill into law. The court-imposed deadline is February 26th. Opposition parties have expressed doubts about those Senate changes, and the government says it's waiting to see the whole revised bill. A decision could come as early as Thursday after cabinet meets. Adrienne?
All right, we'll be watching. Livia Stefanovic, thanks for this.